Sorry, guys. I'm just getting all the games set up out of the way. Oh, I'm actually feeling tired. I was dragging all day. I blame the rain. I put No Gravity as my my player to watch. The man's going to redeem himself for your earlier game, apparently. Oh, never mind. It's Pob's fault. Why is it always Pablo's fault? That poor man. Pob's just deflecting blame. No problem. So I will post the match info. You guys don't have to join right now, but I do like it to give you guys at least the info for it. So you should find in the stream lobby info channel of IGL. But if you guys want to keep warming up, that is perfectly fine as well. As what up, everybody? I was playing with Majestic Coconut earlier, and we were just trolling in twos. We were trying to go for every single stupid challenge we could. There was like a straight like Rube Goldberg machine goal that we scored last night. It literally hit every part of the map before it went in. Yo, what up, Valk? Oh, dude, there's always pre-jumps. That's not even a question in my rank. We were playing casual, but... we were just doing some crazy stuff. We tried it where we just both drove up the sidewalls while he carried it, and we just tried to, like, pinch it straight in the center of the map. Oh, man. All right. How much water do I have? You know what? Just for you guys, Schmidt, Pablo, and No Grav, I'll get a beer. And you don't even need to redeem hydrates in the chat. It's going to be great. I'll be right back. Yeah. Alright, we're back. We have alcohol. A normal, you don't even need to redeem hydrate command because there's no channel points in here. Alright. So, it's only fitting, now that we have all of our alcohol in tow, and we kind of go over our keys to the game and look at the matchups here tonight. As both these teams, so we kind of go... Oh, I gotta mute myself because theater mode is kind of wonky. Well, here, I will show you. There you go. Sour Monkey. It's a triple. Sour triple. Alright, boys. So we're going to go to the matchups page here so I can actually start talking a little bit. So tonight, we have Empire Lost Hope versus Zero Chance Esports in our first game of the night. Never mind, why is RLB up here? Uh-oh, our slides are broken. Hold on. This isn't good. Oh, we're on the wrong profile page, that's why. Hold on. We're still good. Here we go. Oh, dude, so they have like a kind of backwards way of doing the stat things, unfortunately. Alright, so we have Empire Lost Hope, as I was saying, versus Zero Chance Esports, and my player to watch. Both these teams coming in with decent records. Empire Lost Hope, unfortunately, having a low goals per game average, but Zero Chance up near the top. Sub-Zero doing a great job. Sly as well with their goals per game average. But my player to watch here tonight is going to be No Gravity, as Pablo and Schmidt do a great job supporting him normally, as he will look to gain a little space and mechanically inclined. And we'll see what he can do tonight. And my player to watch on the side of Empire Lost Hope is going to be Mr. Anderson, who is their team captain. Seems to be their best all-rounder for the most part. And he's definitely a dangerous player when he gets control of the ball. So we'll see how each team can kind of measure up here tonight. Zero Chance sounds sus? Exactly. Alright, so who decided on the name Zero Chance? I'm kind of curious. Since the PS4 days, oh man. Struth. Yeah. So I've always wanted to make like a really punny team name, but I always wanted the three initials that make up like the team name, I've always wanted to be N, M, and E, so it sounded like enemy. So I thought, like, No Mercy Esports would be a really cool team name. An enemy comes in here with his team name RLB. The Edgelord himself. So guys, we have just a little bit till our game here. Let me get some predictions in the chat. Who's going to be able to take this one? Sly in here as well. So, ready to sub. Unless he gets the start over one of the other ones. Hello? Sly's goals per game looked actually pretty good, though. I think he's the highest on the team. Yeah. So, with my overlays for the matchup page, I've been trying to do what the other casters do and make separate screens. So, like, I don't have to change it in between each game, and I epically failed today. Here I am trying to save myself work, and I'm just making more. Alright. He has Zero Chance Esports in here just waiting on Empire Lost Hope. My Discord is all messed up. I don't know what's going on. Yeah, so Schmidt, if you look in the IGL channel, if you look in the stream lobby info, I did ping the other captain, Mr. Anderson, with the lobby info. Normo, we might have to get Gil's hit squad into takedown Zero Chance Esports. Gil's hit squad. Thank you for following, Jonah. Reunited? Exactly. So, Pobs and Schmidt and Nograv, for those of you that don't know or haven't been in my stream before, so whenever a team does not show up to a match, I like to make sure everyone's time is worth it, that they know their time is valued for making the commitment to come and play at a certain time, even if the other team doesn't show up. So I get Anemone and the other boys to play them as Gil's hit squad, and they have not lost a match on stream yet. Or should I say, lost a series on stream. They have lost a match. But I make them play a best of five against whatever team's available. So we might be having them play here tonight. Right before... It serves as a good warm-up to their next match. Reunited. Pobs, you might want to try and message him again, by the way. I don't see any messages from him. Looks like he's offline. I might try pinging. Oh, okay, Ja. Yeah, mine's messing up, too. Ja, do you need me to whisper you the game info through Twitch? I can, No, it's, like, messed up for, like, a lot of people. So, like, I'm not... So, Schmidt, he's actually in here. He's in the Twitch chat. Okay. Alright, no problem, Ja. Yeah, I realize that kind of stuff happens. Discord was being messed up for me, too. I couldn't actually send any messages, which is why it was wigging out for me. Alright, it's looking like we're getting the boys in here. And I think we have everyone. As we go down to the pitch. Empire Lost Hope versus Vero Chance Esports. So Mr. Anderson, my player to watch on the side of Empire Lost Hope. And No Gravity, my player to watch on the side of Zero Chance Esports. Who will triumph here in this battle at the top? Tier 1 matchup. As Pobs. Just gonna defend on the back wall. Caps back down in front. Pobs across mid. King. Good challenges, Mr. Anderson, up for this. Off the backboard, no grab. Just gonna track this one down, cuts it mid. No grab, putting him on skates. Has an open net, and he bangs it home. No grab, so wasting no time. My player to watch on the side of Zero Chance Esports, cutting through the defense and making it look easy for the first goal. Mr. Anderson. Face-off will come to no grab. We'll go for a little flip reset. We'll go over the top of Cap. Back to mid. Schmidt. We'll be able to take this one down to corner. Mr. Anderson. Out as Pobs. Touch pass across. No grab with a chance. Off the backboard and King. Deflecting it away. As Pobs. Keeping it alive. Good pressure here from Zero Chance. No grab. Shot to the short side. King blocks that one away. Mr. Anderson almost own goaling. It does. And no grab. Getting a second on the board. Alibite, not the method you thought it was going to happen. Takes a good shot to the short side. King had a hard time getting over to that ball. Mr. Anderson maybe a little bit of a panic mode save. So with a minute gone, Zero Chance up 2-0 as King. Cross mid. Pobs. Back in. Mr. Anderson. Looking for a little lead. Pass as Caps. Trying to get the doink on it. Back out in front. No grab. To the far side as King. Good pinch. Still out in front. No grab. Just going to doink it back down to Schmidt. Lead pass out to Pobs. Broken up by Cap. No grab. Spying time for his team to rotate as Schmidt comes back. Pablo. Off the sidewall. Back in front. No grab. Looking for the demo rotation and Cap. Able to get the block away. Schmidt can't find that one. No grab. Last man for a second as he'll deflect this one right into Mr. Anderson. Pobs cross mid, some space underneath him. Able to get the second hit. Looking for the pass down in front, and Kingfisher hopping the route. Long shot from Cap. Off the post, back out in front. And Mr. Anderson able to put his squad within one. Kingfish, great lead pass out the Cap. And Mr. Anderson, he'll take another faceoff. Bumped into this one. No grab. Dangerous feet. Back down in front. Cap. Able to get the hit, but Pablo able to secure the dribble. Back down. No grab. We'll look for a little play off the wall. Dunks it back down in front. Chance here for Schmidt. And blocked away by Mr. Anderson. Pobs. Back in as King. Through mid. No grab. Going to pass it down to corner to Schmidt. He has to pre-flip to get over this in time. Still out in front. Pobs. Can't get any power on that as King cuts in, and no grab, taking this one away. Gets the reset shot as that one not going to get to net as Mr. Anderson will hop that route. Pobs, long shot, good redirect by no grab, and he's got his hat trick. No grab popping off here tonight as Pobs, a great lead pass, hits him right on the money in midfield. And Zero Chance Esports leaving it all in the pitch in game one. Schmidt. Faceoff will come to Mr. Anderson. He's going to look to follow through. Still has plenty of boost trying to get back to it. Has no grab. So dangerous when given time. He'll just force the 50 across. He'll go for the demo rotation, but King already up the wall. So he'll just steal boost on his rotation out. Cap, long shot. That one just off as no grab. Pinches up the sidewall. Three players right around that, as Cap is now the sole last man. He'll just take the 50 right on top of Schmidt's car. Schmidt, with some control, puts it down mid, looking for a little dunk play. But Mr. Anderson gets across, pops. Lead pass, no grab, breaking that up as Cap just going to score the open net. As Cap, a good read on that passing play that came out. Pops trying to get it over to no grab. Doesn't have enough mustard on it, and Cap making him pay. So 2-3. Empire lost hope, fighting their way back into this game. Mr. Anderson, good pass over to Cap, broken up by Pobs. Schmidt, next man in. He'll waffle this one down the corner as no grab. Can't get the pre-flip across as Cap off backboard. Pobs, good read. Gets a bump on the player, I think, instead of the ball. But no grab. To the sidewall again. Cap doing a great job tracking the ball and making that a nice hard to save shot there for Schmidt. King can't get to that. Cap 2v1 in the backfield. He'll try and pre-flip across. Gets the touch. Cap he's going to try and steal the boost out from under him. Still pressuring on the ball. That one off the post out in front. Now 2v1 the other way. Pobs can't get the deflection mid as he'll just chase the boost. Back pass over to Schmidt. Cap touches this one over. Cap looking far side. Mr. Anderson as Pobs blocks that one out. Pobs against Kingfish. Off the sidewall. Back down in front. No grab. Not able to track it down. As Mr. Anderson with some speed through mid. Met by Schmidt. Cap back out as Pob plays this one into King. Over to Mr. Anderson. Back pass to Cap. Good little tic-tac-toe play as Schmidt able to demo as he will buy his team time. Mr. Anderson gets a demo back down in front. Cap kind of all alone against Pobs here, and Mr. Anderson going to rush over to help. No grab. Pass over to Pobs. Recenter. Cap able to get the hit. Still a chance here for Schmidt. Looking to get back to this ball as he'll just steal the boost and cut back in on the ball. 8 seconds left. No grab. Off the sidewall. Cap just going to take his time as the lead pass comes out. That one tracking towards net. Mr. Anderson still back down in front, and no grab. Able to dunk it down, and Zero Chance Esports taking game one. But it was most certainly a battle. Empire lost hope. Not giving an inch. As Cap doing a good job of reading the passing plays, reading the setups on the side of Zero Chance Esports to try and get him back into that one. But no grab. My player to watch on the side of Zero Chance getting a hat trick in this one to secure the bag. So we go to game two. So roster is going to stay the same. Both teams have a sub here tonight. Sly waiting in the wings and Taxi waiting for Empire Lost Hope as Pobs up the sidewall. He's going to look for a shot to the far side. Schmidt right there. The demo almost getting caps as no grab. Forced to buy time. 50 comes to the far side. Schmidt. Give him a touch. Kingfish back down as this one popped in by Cap. Pobs can't deflect it away. Chance here for King as this one still waffled down in front. No grab. Big save. As Pobs can carry this one across mid. Tries for a little flipper as no grab. Back down in front. Mr. Anderson, a long clear. And zero chance. He's trying to take a little control there. Mr. Anderson, a great block in. Caps keeping the pressure alive for Empire Lost Hope as Pobs up to no grab. No grab again. So dangerous when he has time. Able to put it on. And Pobs, a great setup pass. And just a nice little touch up the wall. Doesn't even hit ceiling as no grab. Able to find the shot on. Kingfish, good face-off. Mr. Anderson, look at our pressure right away. Shot to the backboard, and Pobs able to track it down. Caps right back in. Schmidt, sidewall bounce. Pobs turns it back to mid. Broken up by Anderson. Pobs trying to escape this one. Almost gets bumped off the ball. Dangerous as he takes it back down in front. Caps steals this away. No grab across the front. As he will wait for boost. He'll just opt for a 50 along the wall. Nobody getting it as Cap cuts back, shot from King, far side, and Pobs able to get the saves. Pobs has been so good on defense here for Zero Chance Esports as he's going to try and get a goal here this round. And Pobs, defense to offense. The man is looking like the MVP of Game 2 already. Pobs, two excellent saves to set up this long clear. Kingfish, good touch over as Mr. Anderson brings it back in. Schmidt, chance to center. Good challenge as Pablo drop pass to no grab. No grab, can't read it as Kingfish 2v1 the other way. King up, lets it go past as that's a shot. Mr. Anderson trying to get back across, and Schmidt from downtown sends that one in. And much the mirror of the first game, 3-0. Coming out as Empire gonna look to fight back in this one. Still 3 minutes left. Anybody's game. Mr. Anderson gets bumped off that ball as Pobs up to no grab. Pass back to Pobs. Up over one. Pobs down to no grab. Looking for a redirect as Mr. Anderson was coming across. They felt the defense coming from that direction. And tried to redirect it out in front, but this one, Schmidt, shot on Cap. Able to, can't get the block as that one comes off the backboard, and Schmidt gonna make him pay. So unfortunate there, Caps, oh so close to getting this pinch save. Drops back down in front for Schmidt. And Empire, a tough road to climb if they want to get this game going. No grab. Try for a little musty across mid. Anderson, great pass in front, but Pobs already reading that. No grab. Pass to Pobs. Back to no grab. Tried to touch pass it to Schmidt, who was on that far side. Schmidt. Good deflection up as no grab comes across. Schmidt still there. Gets a shot away as Cap. Able to get the save. Anderson backed out to mid. Pobs. A good read on that. Anderson, this one gonna hop down in front to the far side. Kingfish there and able to dunk it down. Kingfish, Johnny on the spot after this nice 50 from Mr. Anderson on the sideline. Had two people that he beat to that ball. Fake kickoffs from both teams as Pobs steals this one. Pobs to the backboard, down in front, no grab, shot on Schmidt, able to, no, he hits it off the post, had a lot of daylight to shoot at, and Pobs will deflect it back in. Cap Looked almost certainly like a goal out in front, but... Kingfish. Looking to come back. Demo by Mr. Anderson trying to set up Cap as that shot. Trying to sneak out mid. Mr. Anderson. The far side, Pop. Lead pass to no grab. Cap able to block it away. Schmidt. Back down inside. Can't get the bumps of Mr. Anderson to launch this one mid. That one back down in front. Kingfish with a chance. And Schmidt. All over that ball. No grab. Far side pass to Pops. To no grab. Looking for the backboard. Still there. As Kingfish. Not able to get the hit. Schmidt. We'll rail this one straight up. Back down. Pops getting a piece of it before it comes back. Kingfish. Back to his own end. No grab. Just going to put it in. As an unfortunate touch here from Kingfish, was trying to send it down the field. Ends up getting a little more of it than he thought and putting it right back out in front for no grab. But Empire just trying to build some momentum heading into game three as they will need to reverse sweep after this. Zero Chance Esports going to take a two-game lead. Just 40 seconds left. Pops. Back down. Kingfish through mid. Has Mr. Anderson trailing him. Mr. Anderson takes the shot and in. As the defense. Kind of nowhere to be seen on this side of Zero Chance. Pops and no grab on the far side. Trying to get back for the rotation. No grab. Good face off. He'll steal boost. Plays it back down into Schmidt. Clobbered by Mr. Anderson as Pobs, last man. Gets a flick. Mr. Anderson making a game of it. Empire lost hope. Not losing hope yet, so to speak. Mr. Anderson. Long flick out. And he was my player to watch on the side of Empire Lost Hope. Looking for a miracle comeback with 18 seconds left. No grab. That one down to mid. Pobs not able to find it. Mr. Anderson, great bump. Looking to put it into the open net. And does Mr. Anderson doing it all for Empire Lost Hope. Great bump. Follows through. Gets the ball. So it'll all come down to this next faceoff. Empire Lost Hope looking to tie the game up. Just going to send the house. Caps, wave dash face off, come to no grab. They play it off the sidewall. Mr. Anderson gets a long clear. Gets the tap back down to mid, still out in front. Chance here, Kingfish not able to get to it as no grab dunks it down to the far side. And Zero Chance Esports taking a stranglehold of the series, up 2-0. So Empire, maybe thinking about a sub. We'll see if they stick with the roster to the bitter end. They're going to stick with it as no grabs. Pob and Schmidt look to close it out here against a team that has played neck and neck with them for the most part. Empire Lost Hope. They get the first goal here. I think they're maybe able to take a game back. They've done such a good job playing from behind for the most part. As this one gonna roll back out in front. As this one goes over a cab. No crap. Trying to play it back to his own teammate. Pops. Back in a long clear. Mr. Anderson looking to recenter. Mr. Anderson, great shot on. Huge save from no grab. Still back out in front. Cap off the post. Still down in front. And Pops. Able to get the touch over top. Pobs gets a reset. Back down to Schmidt, who can't bury it as Mr. Anderson comes across. And now odd man rush the other way. No grab. All alone. Mr. Anderson going to peel off. Looking to play the hit instead. No grab. Great control through mid. Schmidt not able to take the 50, so Pobs will cut in. This one. Going back. Mr. Anderson, a long shot. Schmidt's able to find. 50 will come all the way back. Kingfish just going to buy a little time, take some boost. As no grab. Great 50. Looks for the far center. As Pobs, he'll cut back in. Jobs. He'll wait as Schmidt. Pass over to no grab. This one going to go backboard and down as Kingfish gets a piece of it. Not all of it as Mr. Anderson forced to doink it away as Pobbs was rushing him. Schmidt can't get the read. So now Mr. Anderson plays it deep. No grab. Immediate challenge. Off the post. Back out in front. Cap. Right back to Kingfish. And he'll take the shot and score. So Empire Lost Hope has been playing from behind the previous two games. Now gets the first goal. We'll see if they can hold the lead. As zero chance. The first time they've been down. Kingfish. We'll see how they can respond. Schmidt. Demoed from behind by Kingfish. King. Perfectly read by Nograv as he'll touch pass to himself. Nograv up and over one. That one on and Cap. Able to block it aside. Pob challenges him back out through mid. Mr. Anderson. He'll wait on the touch as Nograv. Flying to this one. Looks for a center as he did not have enough boost to get to it. Schmidt. Nice shot. Short side in. Schmidt tying this one up for zero chance. Great offensive pressure. Pobbs. A nice touch pass off the wall as he beat his man up to the air. Pops back down Mr. Anderson. He'll meet this one. Schmidt dunked down in front. No grab with a chance. And King sends it on along Mr. Anderson. Demos his cap trying to set this one up. Short side. And Schmidt able to get the pre-jump over him. Still in front. Kingfisher back down to Cap. Tries to take the shot. Nobody able to hit it. Mr. Anderson with the pre-jump from mid. And Pobbs will push this one along. So some hectic few moments there for Empire Lost Hope. Schmidt met by Mr. Anderson. Pobbs. He'll doink it off the wall as no grab looks to challenge. Kingfish. This one, Cap with a pre-jump shot on, and this will return out to mid as the back pass from Mr. Anderson. No grab. Perfect read off the sidewall as Cap gets it. Pop trying to touch it back in as King plays it to mid. Schmidt trying to hold this one up, but two players there on the side of Empire Lost Hope. Cap looking to get down to the corner. No grab. Touch to mid, read by Mr. Anderson. Gonna look for an angle of his own. Nice pass down to Kingfish. Pobbs not able to find it. No grab with a chance to clear the corner and does. As Kingfish, another nice challenge. Still down in front. And Schmidt will follow through. Schmidt for the shot. Cap. Good lead pass. Broken up by no grab. He'll get a second touch for a shot as Mr. Anderson sends this one deep. Schmidt. Flutter that one out to mid. As Pobbs looking to rush it. Good 50, and Cap going to push it up the wall. Cap looking for a pass down to Kingfish. Looking to tee it off his car. Mr. Anderson, Kingfish on the demo rotation, but it's coming slowly back towards midfield. Pobbs. Cap. Again, Cap doing a good job sustaining the pressure here for Empire Lost Hope. Pob. Pinch in as Kingfish off the sidewall. No grab. Back down to himself as Kingfish launches this one deep. A good redirect from Mr. Anderson. Back down in front. Kingfish not able to get it. No grab with a touch. And with 41 seconds, Schmidt going to take a blast to the backboard. Two players up as Mr. Anderson can't beat no grab. Kingfish tries to take the shot as Schmidt steps into him. Pops. A lot of space down as Mr. Anderson hits this one away. Back into Schmidt. Perfect redirect. Still back out in front and no one there. As Pobbs was already on the rotation back to D. Pobbs. Kingfish. Far side pass. Nobody there as Mr. Anderson can't get it. Pobbs. Chance to end it. Short side. Back out of front. Schmidt off the board. And no one able to bury. No grab. Looking to follow through. Schmidt. I can't see the ball yet as no grab tries to wave dash across. And Schmidt. Once that one back, had plenty of daylight to shoot at. As he'll look to capitalize here instead. Mr. Anderson to the backboard. Down in front, Cap. Turns this one aside, Pobbs. Back up the sidewall, plenty of time. Another dangerous player when given some of that space. Schmidt A little double off the wall, back down in front, and no grab buries it. And your winners are going to be Zero Chance Esports, as they took three nail-biting games for the most part. Empire Lost Hope coming back in the first two, had the lead here in the game three. But Zero Chance showing their perseverance, able to tie it up, send it to overtime, and get the win out here tonight. Schmidt doing a good job as no grab. I still want to play that Gil Hitman squad though. What up, Prodigio? Alright. I don't want to exit yet just in case you guys are saving replays. Sly and Taxi AFK in the lobby. Schmidt absolutely bullied by me in the cast. Well, unfortunately, Schmidt, their game is okay, if you guys wanna play him to warm up an enemy, I'm okay with that. It gives the viewers just a little bit to watch. I miss Open Nets to so much. Well, in the meantime, I will change all my overlays over. Alright, it's just gonna be STS, STS, Schmidt. We got a Normo in here. Rowan needs 5 minutes. Well, what a series, boys. The 3-0 sweep. Zero Chance popping off tonight. No grab. Heard my call out as him as my player to watch, immediately scoring a hat trick in game one. Maybe I'll do it to Schmidt next time. He's going to be my player to watch next game. Schmidt going to get a hat trick all on his own. No help, no passing plays. He's just going to take it to the rack. I mean, they did come at you relatively fast. That one that bounced off the backboard, I mean, you had like a microsecond to make that decision, so. I had a Hattie in the series earlier. Too late. Fears turning years of 11 too late. Pops had an insane pre-jump. This is shaping up to be like a Gil story. So there I was. Friday night. Out there drinking. Hit the nuttiest pre-jump you'll ever see. Send it to me? Okay. Alright, hold on. We're gonna put this up on screen. Let's see. There's Schmidt. Pablo. The pre-jump? Oh my god! This man was going for the challenge in the corner. Pre-jump across the universe. The man just hangs out in midair for 20 seconds. Taro. We're literally trolling the series. We did a good job locking it down, at the very least. Yeah, it should be playoffs after this week. There should be an announcement in the IGL portion. So you have to have all of your... if you have a bye week game, it needs to be processed and in. Otherwise, it results in a double forfeit. So any division that's under 16 teams automatically go into playoffs. So if you have more than 16 teams in your division, you have to be within the top 16. Yeah, I kind of figured when you said you had lost earlier. Alright, we got Coconut in here, Rowan. Has been gone 7 minutes. So we sub Brick in instead. Schmidt does not have a third. Pobs is coming. Okay. So we get a chance to see Sly, who says he's a champ one tonight. One up, Coconut. Coconut, we're drinking on stream tonight. Oh, where's the cat jammy moment? Pobs can't join the server. Norma has redeemed Hydrate. Thank you for worrying about my health. Alright, we're gonna remake. Or not. We remake. Vamos. Same info. There's Pobs. All right, we're Gucci. So we have a normal brick and majestic coconut versus Pob Schmidt and Sly. On the other hand, a battle of the STS boys is ensuing as Gil's Hit Squad can be set to take on Zero Chance Esports. Great block from Brick, back out in front of Pablo, able to bury it. Pablo doing a good job getting back out in front as Sly forces the 50 from Brick. So 1-0 for Zero Chance early on. As Brick, good demo as he'll pursue this one up the wall, read by Sly. Sly, great wall pinch, back down in front, chance for Pablo, and he's got a double. Sly, a great pass, gets the read, and then the double pass as he taps it off the sidewall. Schmidt, being the cheerleader of his squad, yelling encouragement from the backfield. As Pobs, another shot on, and he's got a Hattie here in the first 30 seconds. And Enormo, the cheerleader for the other side. Coconut, you calling a celebrity shot? Do I just join your team? Sly, he'll take the 50 as this one. Back down, Majestic Coconut trying to set up a play, but Pobs hard to the sidewall. Enormo, pass down in front, chance here for Brick, and he buries it. A great pass for Enormo, so went from zero to hero in the course of 7 seconds. If Sly's champ one, I'm wood three. Yeah, I'm recycling bin five. Brick. Face off will come back to Schmidt. He's looking to get some points on the board as Enormo deflects this one away. Sly, great read on that as Pobs up for this. Plays it down to the far side. Enormo, great touch through as Sly again has been challenging so aggressively on that midfield line. Schmidt back in as Coconut, far corner to Brick. Sly up for it. He'll miss this as he'll look to just wave dash across. Brick going to follow in as Pobs is going to track it off the sidewall. Looks for the wave dash. Still gets a hit on it. Back out as Schmidt. Enormo, last man. He might be demoed as he'll just play it back, forcing Schmidt to go touch it. Still down in front. Coconut feeds it over. Pablo shot on, and Coconut, a big save. Enormo Finally able to get the clear downfield. Brick. He'll peel off as Coconut. Looking to own goal. Back down as Enormo.
It's in our net.
Smacks it to the corner. The hot mic saying it's in our net. Coconut. Back down Schmidt. Far side. Brick able to get the save. And Enormo. Long shot. Sly. Far side to Schmidt. As this one broken up. Chance here for Brick. Over one. Pops last man. And Brick slamming it to the sidewall as he tried to sneak it under Pablo. Good play by Anemone. The bump back down in front of Majestic. Coconut took the shot, but Schmidt coming up huge for his team as Sly. Forcing this one out. Brick across mid. This one in the air for Anemone. Sly all over the field thus far. Pobs. Shot to the backboard. An enemy can't get the read. Schmidt. Open net. He missed another. You don't love it. As Pobs. Trying to play it back in. Schmidt. He's got the yips. As this one gonna roll in from Brick. Schmidt saying that's three now. So, Prodigy, I wasn't sure if you watched the last series, but unfortunately Schmidt missing two relatively open nets as he's going to try and hit this one instead. Schmidt, good control, looking high and in. Schmidt breaking his curse as he hits an air dribble from midfield. Enormo being pressured by Pobs to jump a little early there. So 2-4. Enormo. Sidewall as Schmidt. Back down to mid. Coconut slamming this one in as Sly. We'll take it across. Enormo big shot. Schmidt. Sidewall. Good read for Pobs. Off the post. Still back out in front. Pobs gets the deflection and Brick. Two huge saves as he'll advance this one on for Coconut. Coconut. Looking for a touch pass, Schmidt. Brick. Sidewall is Pobs, looking to clear it down. Looks for a second touch, Enormo. Gets the read, has one to beat. Enormo, Schmidt, last man, Enormo. Tried to put it to the far side, but did not have the boost to get there. Enormo just playing bully ball on the side of the net. As Sly, over top, Pobs. Sends it deep, Enormo can't find it, so a Majestic Coconut will take over. Enormo, great pass, over to Brick, broken up by Sly. Sly doing a good job getting in the passing lanes here in game one. Shot on, and Pobs able to throw that one in. So 45 seconds left in game one. Sly, little air dribble as Enormo deflects it away. Pobs, double tap off the wall, gets another read. Pablo, what a pass! As I'm sure he did not really mean to do that. Three players stuck in the corner as Coconut takes it across. Pobs. Brace up the route to the backboard. Enormo. It's a pinch as Sly. Right back in. Coconut. Cross mid. Gets another touch. Center back down as Brick. Sends this one deep, but zero chance esports.
It's in our net.
It takes another game. Sly.
In our net?
Alright, so we have time for one more game before their series. So I'm sure this one will run a little bit of time off the clock. Gil's Hit Squad looking to defend their honor, need a win. As Enormo sends this one deep right in as Brick challenges him. Ronnie up the sidewall. Enormo, good touch back in, but Schmidt already on the wall to read that. Brick up and over one. Brick, good centering pass. Nobody there as Pobs able to send it deep to Schmidt. Good redirect, and Enormo with a big save. The demo comes out as Sly hops back in. Ronnie not able to reach it. Schmidt looking for a pinch down in front. Pablo with a chance, and he tucks it under the bar. And second chance again off these passing plays. Sly being so aggressive on his offensive rotation, causing havoc. Thirty seconds gone. Sly takes a shot as Ronnie comes back down to Normo. Unfortunately, I don't know if his controller disconnected or something. He did not move. Oh, Normo messaging the other team. Oh wait, Enormo's a keyboard and mouse player, never mind. He's unplugged his keyboard? He's plugged it back in? Little musty flipper goal? Pobs to the far side. Brick gets a touch out to mid. Ronnie back down to Brick, looking for a redirect, but Ronnie, he'll take that open net goal. There's the challenge in mid. Schley and Schmidt just kind of hanging out near the midfield line. So for those of you just joining us, this is just a friendly match before our next game starts. I've always joked that when a team does not have the other team show up, I have them play against my own personal Hit Squad, which is in the blue. Gil's Hit Squad taking on another tier one team here tonight. As Sly hits it back into Brick out front. Pablo long clear. And Normo, he'll catch this one as this one hops back down and in. Sly, what an angle from that challenge. Gonna get the info all prepared. Sly, there's a little 50 shot out in front, and Sly, that's two from the pinch. Sly, his challenge is angled towards Nut. As comes in strong with another pinch. Ronnie forces a 50. Sly able to take this one across. Brick far side. Ronnie off the sidewall. Normo up for this one. Normo can't get the reset, so Schmidt will take this one away. in front, tries for the demo. Ronnie sends it in. Sly, another good read into a redirect. And Sly has been very picky with his challenges, has got great angles on his deflections, always to a teammate or onto net. Brick, good feed out in front. Pablo with a read. As he'll get the block, Sly not able to find it. And Ronnie able to get the open net. Schmidt. Knocking this one deep as Sly looks for an angle back out in front, and Pobs pushes it back. Brick, he'll get a touch, good control. Brick looking for a little doink pass. Schmidt. Ronnie up over, dunk back down in by Pobs. He'll grab some boost and go for it as Enormo trying to maintain some control. Brick over the top as Sly deflects it back out towards mid, but Ronnie already on the route. Ronnie trying to tuck it under as Pobs will rush over him. Pobs pitch down to mid, trying to demo an enemy off this as Ronnie back over to Enormo. Shot. Pobs able to make the save. Enormo still back out in front. Sly with a chance to clear and does. As this one was off the sidewall looking for Sly as he did not have enough boost to get up to that. Pobs. Brick out to mid. Sly will let Schmidt take a whack at it. Schmidt off the sidewall right into Ronnie. Up over the top of one, back down to mid. Pops shot on, so Enormo will take it. Ronnie, big dunk down in front, stopped by Sly. Brick shot short side, an enemy stopped by Pobs. Pobs is so good on defense. Hard to find a seam as Ronnie tries for the flip reset instead. Brick can't pressure Mouse as Pobs gets a long clear. And Gil's hit squad finally gonna meet their match here tonight in the form of Second Chance Esports, or Zero Chance Esports, I'm sorry. The squad of Schmidt, Sly, and Pobs able to take down the undefeated Kings. All right, so we will create the match info here. Oh, yeah, Normo, I'll PM it to you on Discord. Wait, what? There we go. Alright, so we have our second matchup of the night, RLB. All set to take on the Big Brains. As my player to watch here tonight on the side of RLB, gonna be Ronnie. A solid playmaker, extremely quick to the ball. And on the other side, Belial is going to be my player to watch. The main setup artist for the squad. As RLB waiting to get all their players in. And it's looking like everyone able to join Ronnie and Normo and Brick. Playing against Top Cat, Belial, and Roxy. As Top Cat not able to find this as Ronnie takes a shot to the far side. Ronnie. Back pass, lays it down for Brick. Shot on and Roxy able to get a lead pass. Ronnie. Pinch, sends it to the far side as Brick trying to track this one down. Deflection back to a Normo. Top Cat. Hitting this one up, Ronnie. Gonna take a shot as Belial sends it wide. Roxy, long shot. Deflection out in front. Belial back down as Roxy. Gonna leave this as Belial. Touch over one. Brick screams in for this one as Top Cat. Trying to follow through this one. Normo. Little flip pass broken up by Roxy. Nice little double touch by Roxy. Brick forced to come over. Brick stood up but still gets the boost. Brick looking to get a center. SL50 this one up the wall. Roxy takes over as we'll put that mid. Normo with a shot to the sidewall. Normo back down in front. Ronnie with a chance. Puts it far side and out as Roxy is trying to get back across. Brick can't 50 through as Roxy try and track this one down. Belial pass interrupted by Ronnie. Roxy back in and Brick able to take this one across through mid. Roxy sidewall, the demo rotation comes out, both players, and Ronnie huge save as Roxy deflects this one up. Ronnie got back across a net. Normo was in trouble in front of the net. Two players trying to demo him off that ball as Roxy took the shot. And Brick back in. Good pass across. Nobody there to bury it as Roxy send this one out. Ronnie back down. Normo off sidewall. Back down in front. Ronnie shot far side and missed again as he seems to have caught the Schmidt syndrome. Brick back down in. Ronnie, good control now. Top Cat trying to get over to him in time and does. Brick trying to rush it forward. Brick goes around one but can't beat Roxy in front. Normo, no pinch there as Ronnie send it down. Schmidt. Ronnie, the pass. Brick, good 50 out in front of Normo with a chance. Shot on Roxy, big save. And Brick trying to carry it back in. Bumps out Ronnie. I had the bully cast just, Schmidt. I have no idea what kind of casting style you're going to have me do. So I got to get my shots in now. Brick trying to play it mid. Norma got to back off as the shot comes through. Sidewall. He'll send it deep. Norma with some speed. Belial. Brick. Chance. Shot. Backboard. Still down in front. Ronnie bumped from behind by Top Cat. Now it's 3v1 the other way. Normo. He'll just take the 50 to the sidewall. Normo. He'll let Ronnie have this as it deflects back out towards the front of the net. Normo. Good control. He'll try and rush past. Double demo comes out from RLB. Answered by Belial as he gets one of his own. Roxy has done a good job sending clears in and just rotating in, allowing his team to take shots as Top Cat tried to get the center out to Belial. Still down in front of Normo. Demo's another one. Brick can't handle it as Ronnie. He'll take it through mid. Beats one. Sidewall. Zero boost as Brick just going to play it back down in front. Good deflection. Normo there, but not going to challenge yet. As now he will. Takes the shot. Crossbar down as Ronnie up for this one. Dunks it back down in front. And after a hectic amount of shots from RLB there in those last 30 seconds, finally able to put one in as Ronnie comes down from the heavens, finally beats Roxy out in front. Brick. Through one, he's gonna look to center. Has a man far side, broken up by Belial. Ronnie. Roof shot. Scoops it back down and in. Roxy. Big shot at an enemy. A huge save. Ronnie. Over one. Belial cuts in for this. Belial looking dangerous. And an Ormo deflects it away. Still a chance here for Top Cat as he tried to pre-jump it. Ronnie. Over Belial. Brick. Sends it deep. 21 seconds left. Just need to buy some time. Brick. They'll rotate back as Top Cat gets a doink. An Ormo. Deflects it back to his own corner as Ronnie pre-flips across. Ronnie back down in front. Roxy with a shot short side and deflected by Normo. And with 4 seconds left, Brick just looking to add the icing to the cake. Belial cuts back across. Still a chance. And RLB gonna take game one. Ronnie with the lone goal. But excellent defensive coverage from RLB in that match, working as a team, making some key saves on some of the members of the Big Brains. Roxy holding it down on defense for the other side. Only got beat once by Rowan. Or Ronnie, I'm sorry, to that short side. And it's looking like Majestic Coconut subbing in as Tech Support and Brick are waiting in the wings. Maybe kind of coaching them a little bit from the spectator mode. As Roxy sends it deep. This one back down in front of Normo. He'll send it on down. This one comes across as Top Cat. Coconut can't get the hit. Top Cat back in off the sidewall and Ronnie. Send it along Roxy back in to the far post and Majestic Coconut with a pinch out. Ronnie down there as Top Cat has to hurry across to block it. Coconut. Far side. Roxy up to Belial. Normo. Back down to corners. Top Cat. Deflect this one out. Ronnie. Coconut. He'll send it deep again. Him and Roxy will play catch here for a second. As the ground pinch trying to come out, Enormo sends it mid. Belial. Shot to the far side. The pre-flip from Roxy can't make it. Top Cat. Long clear. Broken up by Ronnie. Roxy. Back down towards mid. Enormo. This one. Chance for Top Cat, and he buries it. Top Cat. Gets a good touch on this ball. Takes an awkward hop off the wall. And Coconut not able to get to it. So 1-0, the Big Brains. Here in game two. Belial. Trying to get a piece of this. The 50. Come all the way back to Top Cat. Far side pass to Belial. No one able to find it as he'll slam it off the sidewall. Back down in front to Roxy. And it looked like a Normo might have gotten a piece on it. Belial trying for a little scoop. Top Cat back down and in. This one off the sidewall, still out in front. And Ronnie able to deflect it. Still there. Belial shot on, broken up by Normo. Now look out the other way. Normo open net. Plenty of space to shoot at. Roxy comes across. Tries to pre-flip out to it from the half pipe. Coconut to the wall. Belial. Touch back as Enormo takes this across. Backboard. Roxy turns it away as Ronnie. Can't get the dunk as Belial gets a nice touch. Enormo up to Ronnie. Tried to dunk it back down in front, but did not have a great angle. Ronnie, a key block there as that one was headed straight towards their net. Coconut steps into this one. Backboard read as Roxy pushes it wide. Normo, good pinch back to mid. Top Cat, last man. He'll send it over to Belial. Coconut underneath him, but can't beat Roxy. Sends it down. Top Cat Last man, he'll just push it across as Coconut trying to get a scoop back down in front. Normo, he'll weave in and out as Belial waits for the touch. Belial one-on-one against Coconut, and Ronnie will go there to assist. Coconut almost gets dunked by Roxy. Topcat slammed off the ball as Belial trying to hustle back. Normo right into Roxy. Yes, Ronnie. Back down to mid. Roxy with some time. Roxy beats one. Has one to beat. Flicks it up. Normo, last man. Shot on. Topcat able to put it in off the side of Roxy's car. And Roxy doing a great job here. Sustaining the pressure. Flicks it up. It goes for the bump on the goalie. Can't get more textbook high octane offense than that. As a heads up play from the Big Brains, putting them up 2-0 here in game two. Coconut. Sidewall read. Ronnie almost demoed from behind as Enormo leaves it for Ronnie, flicking in! And Ronnie, putting his team within one, a great lead pass to himself, just chips it downfield. The big fake from Enormo. So RLB still need a goal to tie this one up as Ronnie tries to get the read. Enormo to the backboard. Topcat hits it away. Coconut back down in front. Roxy double tap off the backboard. Still there. A chance as Belial will send it wide. Ronnie gets a read. Up for Majestic Coconut. Can't get the hit mid as he pushes it back to Enormo. He'll take it far side as Ronnie just going to grab boost and turn back to it. Ronnie can't beat Topcat as Coconut tries to hop in. Long clear from Topcat. Enormo, good control. Belial back down to mid, forces the 50 across. Chance here for Topcat. Looking backboard as Ronnie will send it deep. Shot by Roxy. Belial trying to get run some interference as Topcat jostled at the line. Good pressure here from the Big Brains. Ronnie will pre-flip clear. Gets a block. Still in front. 9 seconds left. RLB need a goal. Enormo. Back down. Enormo with a chance off the sidewall. Coconut back to it. Ronnie up. Able to deflect it still, but the Big Brains taking a game back. And Roxy, the catalyst for their offensive strikes, has done such a good job challenging these players from RLB in midfield. And Roxy, great decision making that game as well. As Roxy and Topcat doing a good job making the defensive rotations, keeping this game out of the reach of RLB. Who do have some mechanically inclined players. Tech support hopping in for Majestic Coconut. Is Enormo taking this one away. Ronnie looking for a little wall pinch. Comes out. Tex forces the 50 across as Enormo getting pressured from behind. Enormo taking this one out as Ronnie gets a touch over. Topcat able to send it back down to Roxy. Far side for Belial. Shot on. Tech support. Big block back out in front of Topcat. Able to score. Excellent passing play. Roxy finding Belial on the far side for this initial shot, making it really hard for Tex to save. And Big Brains starting off a good follow-up, getting that first goal. Belial shot on Enormo. Back down. Belial sees his man in mid as Roxy has to cut across to find it. Belial, the sidewalls. Ronnie pinches it back down and in. Tech support trying to help him out. He'll fake as Ronnie sends a long clear. Roxy Far side to Tex. Middle clear. Ronnie puts it right in. Great pass from Tex support. Shoots an absolute clanger mid for Ronnie. And Topcat gets a piece of it, but not enough. That would actually messed his last defender up as it did ricochet down to the corner. Belial. 50 to mid. Topcat can't get it as Roxy's all alone. Roxy will turn it back mid. Ronnie forces the 50. Tech support. Cross mid. Topcat. Shot. Backboard. Roxy looking for the read. Shot down to the far side. As Roxy bumps his own teammate. Back in from Enormo. Tech support across. Topcat. Shot on. Ronnie. Big save. As Roxy. Backboard still again, and Tex support gets to clear out. Ronnie up for this one. Demo rotation coming out from Tex as Belial was last man. Enormo will take a long shot as Topcat sends it away. Tex support off the sidewall as Roxy hops in. Ronnie has been my player to watch on the side of RLB for today. Tex, far side. Enormo gets a shot to the sidewall. Belial back down. He gets bumped off as he sticks with it. Topcat and just back down to mid. Good touch by Ronnie. Or Enormo, I'm sorry. As Ronnie will await the clear instead. Tech support gets this one stolen away by Topcat. Center down to Belial. Enormo. Touch pass to himself, but Roxy going to take a shot to the far side, and Tex. A big save to send it all the way down. Tex, good 50. Out in front, Roxy again has been so good on defense for the side of the big brains. Enormo. Touch in as Belial. Send a deep lead pass from Tex to Enormo. Off the sidewall, back down, and Topcat will rush this one away. Tex. On the backboard. Gets bumped off. Tex. Pass to the far side. Ronnie. He'll force the 50 off the sidewall. Back as Enormo. Just wait on this. Tex. Can't get the touch. Chance here for Topcat. Still there. And Ronnie. Be able to take it away. Open net the other end. Ronnie. Looking to pre-flip into it. And he does. Ronnie. Turning garbage into goal. Ronnie, a big save on the goal line to force them to overcommit. Trying to rush down to get that goal to go ahead. But RLB turning the tables. Able to send it back down. Ronnie. He'll leave this one for Enormo. Topcat. Deflected away as Enormo takes this one across. Topcat. Good doink to mid. Tex. Back out. Belial. Shot to the backboard. Enormo. Sends it back to Topcat. Shot short side and it's in. Great placement from Topcat to even this game up. Belial, a great touch initially to set the shot up. Enormo landing back down on his teammate. So 2-2. A minute 13 left to play. Ronnie. He'll rush it. Topcat. Sends it deep. Tech support tracking it along the wall. Over to Ronnie. Topcat with the center. Belial to the far side. And Enormo breaks it up. Roxy. Good touchdown in front. Belial trying to demo from behind as Ronnie will send him on his way. Big fake from tech support as Ronnie was cutting in for the shot. Enormo. Good control. Gets a flipper, but deflected away by Roxy. As Topcat will join this time. Tech support not getting the greatest touch as Ronnie comes back. Topcat shot on as Enormo sends it back down to mid. Roxy. Shot. Stuffed out by Ronnie. Topcat will come back around as tech support. Touch pass down to Enormo. Nobody able to get to that. Ronnie will hop in as he forces a 50. Look out. 15 seconds left. Ronnie Big center, far side, nobody there, and Belial will send it on. They'll look to rush back downfield, but Tex off the sidewall, still down in front. Topcat not able to find it. Roxy to corner, and Normo opts to rush for this. Topcat sends it deep. Belial looking for center, still up. As Belial, recentered opportunity, still down in front, and Topcat not able to find it. So RLB and Big Brains will go to overtime here in game three to determine who gets that pivotal lead to try and close the series out in the next game. Shot, backboard, Ronnie. They'll turn on it. As we'll cut it past one. Ronnie trying to put him on skates, forces the 50 instead. Tex can't locate it as the Normo wins the 50 across mid. Roxy, long shot. Ronnie, last man, able to deflect it away. As Roxy, that one's going to waterfall back down to the far post. Normo over one. Ronnie, let Tex cut in for this as no one able to find it. Roxy, lead pass to mid. And Ronnie, one-on-one against Topcat in the backfield. Off the sidewall. Normo back down in front, takes the pinch shot. Still there, and Roxy off to the races on the other end. Roxy, open net. Ronnie, last man, backboard, out in front, dunk down in front, off the post, still there. Belial takes a shot, and Topcat, back pass into Roxy. Good pressure here from Big Brains. Topcat with a chance shot, backward, posting down and out as Ronnie gets a piece, comes to the far side, but Belial able to end this game, and Big Brains may take a 2-1 series lead over RLB. Roxy again doing an extremely good job defending their half of the field. Three saves, one for Topcat as well, but these shot totals starting to favor Big Brains in a larger way. And my player to watch was Belial Knight. He was defending really well, allowing his team to get these follow-up chances. He was that second man, so just in case Roxy or Topcat missed on the offensive rotation, he was right there to cover. So very rarely noticed, but appreciated nonetheless as Big Brains taking the lead in the series 2-1. As of course there has to be one hot mic moment for RLB.
Gil.
It's in your net. Ronnie. To pinch this one off the sidewall. Normo. Trying to take a shot. Roxy. The far side. Brick will let Ronnie take this one in. The read. As Normo. Still able to keep control. Normo. Back down in front. Roxy. Gets a hit. Brick immediate challenge. Down to Ronnie. That one off sidewall. What a read from Ronnie as he puts it in. What a save from Roxy. Still back out in front. Normo can't bury it. As Belial will try and rush downfield. Sidewall. This one. Kareem deep as a Normo. Topcat trying to find Belial for a redirect to mid. Topcat stuffed out by Ronnie. Brick will step into this one as a Normo. Lead pass, Roxy to the far side. Belial there again. Belial opening himself up as a passing target as Topcat wins the 50 underneath. Roxy with a chance, open net all day, but Normo managed to get around Topcat, who was bumping him a little bit. Topcat. Ronnie keeps it in. Topcat misses on this one. Belial off sidewall. Ronnie back down to mid. Roxy. Step forward into this one is Normo. Deflects it. Ronnie to send it out to mid, and Topcat not going to be able to locate this one. Ronnie with a chance. Dunks it back down in front. Brick with a shot and in. And RLB goes up one here to keep their series hope alive. And it is must-win territory for them. Must force a game five to be able to take the dub here tonight. Ronnie. Says I'm just gonna look at him as Brick sends this one down. Backboard as the deflection comes in. Belial. Shot to the short side, and Normo take this one off the sidewall. Ronnie. Little pre-jump as Topcat finds Belial in midfield. What a pre-jump by Brick for the save. Good game sense there by Brick. Going up for that, knowing the shot was going to be coming through. Ronnie touches this one away. Back down. Belial with a chance. This one up and out as Roxy. Down to the short side. Ronnie will meet Topcat. Gets the block. Can't get the extra. As he'll fake the breezy as Brick comes across mid. Roxy back down as an enemy sends it deep. Belial able to handle it, sends it down to Topcat. Belial, long shot to the backboard, an enemy. He'll send it wide as Brick. Lead pass, Ronnie. Roxy, over to the far side. Topcat takes a hit as Roxy will charge in, and Normo gets a deflection. That one might roll up the sidewall as Topcat has to send it past as Ronnie. Up to Brick, back down, in front for Ronnie, and Roxy able to send it out as a Normo. Topcat, good block, Brick. Come back in, looks for the center as Roxy. He'll send this one away. Brick can't get to it in time as Topcat doesn't have boost. Brick trying to play it over to a Normo, can't get the hit. And now Belial rushing downfield. He's going to try and cut this one back inside. Brick. It's a flick over one. As Topcat bumped off this ball. Now it's a foot race. Ronnie pre-flip shot and in. Ronnie able to get around the defender with a pre-flip. Brick, a huge 50.
After you, Gil.
As he calls out the goal for me. Ronnie, always a character. Brick sends it deep, and Normo can't get a hold of that one. As Belial look for a nice touch back down in front as Roxy. Good deflection, good pressure here from Big Brains. Still down, shot far side, and no one able to find it as Ronnie back through mid. He's looking for a lead pass that's not coming as Topcat sends this one on off the sidewall back down, and Normo cuts it to the side. Roxy back in, Ronnie. Over to Normo, who gets a nice touch. And Belial able to get eyes on. Brick back down as Topcat pushes this one over Normo. With the challenge in the corner. Good pressure here by Topcat as the shot from Roxy smacked away by Brick. Normo 50 all the way out. Roxy far side to Topcat. Normo back down. Roxy shot onto the short side. Deflected away. Still out in front. Belial with a shot as it looked like a Normo was Goomba'd out in front by Roxy. Watch this just to be certain. Roxy stops on the top of a Normo. Ronnie. Demo from Belial. Topcat can't hit that one. Chance here for RLB. Still have the one goal lead as Roxy trying to rush back down the field. Belial trying to cut it back in, but with 1 second left, Topcat looking to make a magic happen. Has a man, Roxy right over as Ronnie. Perfect tracking of the ball, and RLB gonna force a game five.
Let's go.
Roxy again at the top of the table for Big Brains. But Ronnie pulling out all the stops in game four with a pre-flip shot on net that snuck in that gave them the game winner. And he's going to look to see if lightning strikes twice. Game five. It all comes down to this, folks. As Topcat, Belial, and Roxy looking to snag a dub here tonight, but RLB fighting back fiercely in this one. Able to force a game five as a Normo. He'll take the kickoff. Topcat will send it deep as Ronnie. And we have to reset the match as Coconut unfortunately joined. So we're just going to remake the lobby with the same info. As the lobby is back up. Thank you for the follow, Scorpio Buzzcut. What a name. I'm not sure what a Scorpio Buzzcut would be, but it sounds painful. So a reset. We go to game five once more.
I got it.
As Ronnie will take the face off. It comes back to a Normo, broken up by Belial. Brick can't get a handle on this one. Still out in front, and a Normo goes back downfield. The lead pass to Ronnie, broken up by Topcat. Topcat. Ronnie, the sidewall. Putting it back towards us. That dangerous ball out in front in a Normo. Can't get it. Topcat off the sidewall. And Ronnie, another little pre-flip. But ultimately ends up going nowhere as Brick sends it back down into Belial. The Normo shot on as Roxy. He'll send this one deep. Ronnie over to a Normo. This one out in front and in. Roxy doing a great job of burying that one out in front. Topcat. Good little touch up. And RLB. Down one. So game five. Big brains. Sending the house on offense. Brick. Can't force his way through. So Ronnie will take this one. Ronnie, what a touch to the backboard, and Roxy has sewn it up all night as Brick touched the backboard. Roxy will just let Belial handle this one. Shot down as a Normo gets a pinch. Ronnie right there, back out of front. The demo rotation comes through, but not the way you expect. Topcat killing a Normo, but a Normo buying enough time with his little set pass as Ronnie puts that one in. Clip it and ship it. A Normo. Back down. Trying to control this one, but Roxy again. Looking for the follow through. Brick sends it far side. Belial. Back to backboard. Ronnie. Down the corner to a Normo. Can't deflect it along as Topcat hops in. Roxy. Perfect read. Ronnie. Dangerous ball as he takes that one across his net mouth. Roxy, the pinch over top as Topcat launches this one deep. Roxy can't win the 50 against Ronnie, and Brick will take over from there. Brick, 50, come back to a Normo. Normo, all the way back to his own end. Brick gonna need to hustle back as Ronnie on the rotation. Topcat, shot to the far side. Belial, good offensive pressure here from Big Brains. Roxy, center back down. Is Belial just going to back off? Belial with the cat boost. Belial over the top as Normo. This one played right into Topcat as he gets a dunk out in front on Brick. This one sent to the far side. Belial trying to track this one down as Normo cuts it back mid. Belial trying to demo him as this one teeters out in front. Belial redirect pass to Roxy, and Brick will send it along the corner. Ronnie The flip reset pass over to Brick. He was not ready for it. Was going off the initial touch. Brick. Nice doink down to mid, Ronnie. We'll let Brick have this one. He'll look for a 50. Sent to the far side. As a Normo. He'll hop back in, Ronnie. Goes for the backboard. He'll get a double tap. As he'll look for a man in mid. Great pass to a Normo off the backboard. And Brick gonna let Ronnie take the shot now. A Normo, another huge bump. And RLB now taking the lead. A Normo driving this offense, allowing Ronnie to take these shots. And Brick has been there supporting them all along. It was actually Brick's initial clear into that that set the play up. Enormo, backboard, Brick looking for a piece. Dunks it back down in front and they'll pad the goal. As they're up two, with just a minute 24 left to play in game five. Enormo, he'll force this one across as Roxy. Takes this one. Pass down to Topcat. Broken up by Ronnie. Brick trying to hustle this ball. Shot on Ronnie. Can't get the deflection away as Belial will send it along. Enormo. Back down Belial. Far side. Nobody there as Ronnie can't track it down. Topcat with a chance here out in front. And Ronnie just try and handle this. Topcat forces the 50. Belial up the sidewall. As Enormo. Back down to D. Topcat. Off the top of Ronnie's car. As this one skitters out in front. Roxy is going to take it back to his own end. Has no boost. Leaves it up as Enormo. Just trying to track that one down. Off the sidewall. Back down in front of Enormo. Deflecting it away. Roxy with a read to the far side. Topcat can't get a hold of it. As Ronnie rushes down, Beal gets a demo, and this time was trying to set a Normo up with his demo play. Brick, good touch as three people rushing him to corner. Ronnie, another demo comes out. Topcat, with 4 seconds left, and it's looking like RLB are going to be able to take it here tonight. Maybe he's trying to add one more just to pad the stats as Brick touches it, but RLB taking the series 3-2, a nail biter between these two teams.
Well played, Gil. Let's go.
Let's go. Ronnie. 2 goals, a Normo. 3 assists was really the active playmaker there in game five, setting up these goals from Ronnie with the demos and the bumps out in front. And Enormo, I'm hoping you save those replays. I'm going to stay in here just in case for a second. So, guys, we do have one more series here tonight between Full Boost and... Why won't my schedule work? There we go. Between Full Boost and Taka Esports. There you go. Little... little kiss back. Hey, man. That man's my heterosexual life partner, okay? He knows the love is there. So, RLB coming out with the dub here tonight. Zero Chance Esports again winning as well. So both the STS Esports squads winning here tonight due to in part to my casting, I believe. As they get an increase in win rate by 200% when they have me cast. Track it. As Full Boost set to take on Taka Esports next. Here at 10 o'clock, so another 20 minutes away. But what a series, boys. RLB The math adds up, exactly. I'm only one man, but, you know. And I failed basic math. But I tested out in college for whatever reason. I don't know how that happened. Should they have even glanced at my high school records. But I like to think of that I'm big brain. Mayhem Toxic, thank you for the follow. As we just saw a heated series from RLB. As they were neck and neck right up until the end in Game 5. But Enormo and Ronnie kind of being the ultimate deciders there as they teamed up for a lot of those goals out in front. The bumps and demos coming through. Alright. So we're going to kind of set some of the overlays up for next game. But if you guys have any questions in the meantime, I am just here to kind of chat while I do all this. See, I'm not like the other casters where, like, they think ahead and they create, like, multiple scenes so they don't have to change anything during the games. Or, like, during the intermission. But I like to just kind of meme around with you guys, talk a little bit, kind of reflect on the previous series. And I think both those teams going to be a force in their division. As we take a look at the matchup page again, you kind of see Roxy is kind of the driving force of play tonight for Big Brain. Has the second most goals on the team, but a defensive monster, as we saw. So was a great player to watch. Belial, I kind of had my eye on, as he does have the most assists. Those players tend to play that second man role, find a lot of the offensive pressure for a team. But it was definitely Roxy's defense here tonight that kind of made the difference for that team, even though they did end up losing the series 3-2 against RLB. Roxy definitely to be commended. And on the other side, Enormo and Ronnie doing a lot of work, and you used all of their super subs here tonight. As Brick ending up getting the Game 5 win. But Tech Support and Majestic Coconut doing their part as well. And utilizing their subs to the fullest effect, getting a different perspective on the game. Is definitely another part of being a good team. So RLB, take it here tonight. So we set up all of our overlays for the next game. It is a tier 5 matchup in our next game. So it's Full Boost versus Taka Esports. It's a tier 5 3v3. And I've cast Full Boost before. So Chan Taser requesting me again. Looking to come out with another dub. So Fulbu's kind of on a tear. They're 3-1. Still with a bye game to play. But they sport a 73 game win rate. So the games they do play, they do kind of crush. As kind of Okenshi is probably going to be my player to watch for them. He was a defensive force. And a solid passer from the defensive end, able to get like a lot of long clears to the sidewall and find a teammate there. So Taka may have their work cut out for him tonight. So who do you give MVP to for that that series there, Enormo? Let the Oh my god, I didn't realize the Big Brains logo was Bobby Hill, which is an absolute enormous dome. King of the Hill was one of my favorite animated shows along with The Simpsons growing up. So definitely hits home for me. So one more matchup for the night, guys, here in another 15 minutes. But we will be getting into the stats here in just a second as I try and get all my overlays situated. Yeah, STS representing here tonight. Coming out in force. Winning both their games on stream for the boys. Alright, it's looking like we are all set up for next game. So guys, we do have a little bit, but we will check the matchup page here. As we get set, Full Boost versus Taka Esports has looked like it should be a pretty close matchup for the most part. These two teams kind of pretty much dead even with their stats. The saves per game from Taka just a little bit ahead. But the assist from Full Boost, a slight edge. But Okenshee going to be my player to watch on the side of Full Boost. The last time I had casted these guys, he was a defensive monster. As, like I said, able to get a ton of clears. Chantaser, usually the recipient of his passes, but it looks, just from the stats alone, maybe that game was the outlier, as Okenshee seems to be their main scorer, as Chantaser kind of being the one to set him up. And on the other side, my player to watch is going to be Geek Boy, the team captain. Like I said, he is a solid all-rounder, the most goals on the team. And a defensive bastion on the other end, as all three members really contribute on the defense. So it's going to be up to Full Boost to try to put some shots on net, as their forte will be tested here tonight. Alright, Schmidt. So who's your MVP? After playing against Gil's Hit Squad and then watching them, what'd you think? I'll give you the chance to chime in. Ahead of SDS playoffs, of course. As you will be going head-to-head with Rowan and Enormo. And Brick and Zerf going to be on another team. Anemone was the MVP, says Schmidt. Kind of have to agree. Setting those plays up at the end with the bumps, resulting in those two goals that put him ahead, was definitely key. And it is hard when the player is going for the save the entire time as well. All right. 9:50. We'll get the next game set up. As, like I said, let's take a look at our schedule again. We have Full Boost versus Taka Esports, a tier 5 3v3 matchup. Duster in here supporting his boys for Full Boost. Chantazer, Oakenshee. For a dynamic duo, the last time I casted these guys, we'll see if they can continue the trend here tonight versus Taka. Taka, a solid defensive team. Everyone contributing good rotations from their squad. And it'll be up to Full Boost to try and put some shots on. Make a move around and break up that rotation. As Taka has proven to make teams pay that do not shift their defense around. As I will get the lobby set up. Like I said, I do like to leave these teams around 10 minutes or so. Just so they have the information. They're not rushing to get in right at the start time of their game. Just in case something goes wrong. You know, a player needs to use the bathroom or something like that. They do have the lobby info. And there's no problems with them getting in. So Full Boost versus Taka. Dempsey Hammer. What a name. Jack Dempsey. I'm hoping that's what that name takes after. Was a prolific boxer in his time. All right. Putting the lobby up. Jack Dempsey. Alright, well, I'm going to go PM the team captains with this info. Like I said, I do like to give these teams a little time just to get in here. They are warming up. That does give them a chance to notice the lobby info, finish out their games, and go in as warmed up as they can get, so to speak. So this will be my 37th game that I've casted. So my naming conventions aside, it has been a great IGL split for me so far. I've casted a lot of games, met a lot of cool people, and a lot of teams have come back to request more, Full Boost being one of them. This will be the second game that I've cast for them, as I believe they had to skip me last week because their team could not play on either a Tuesday or Thursday night. But I did have a special request for them that they were able to take on tonight. And I'm happy to cast them again. So I'm curious, Dempsey, do you actually like old school boxing? Or do you like the anime Hajime no Ippo, which is another inspiration a lot of people take from it? My name is Jack Dempsey. Are you serious? You gotta be trolling. There's no way. Dude, your parents are awesome. No joke. Yo, is your dad a boxing fan? Is that how that happened? Maybe he just nonchalantly told your mom. She's like, yeah, Jack sounds like a really cool name. He's like, oh my god, I just can't tell her the truth. The This man slid it in on the sly. Your mom probably found out years later. She's like, hey, honey, did you know there was a boxer named this guy, too? He's like, oh, yeah, I had no idea. That's how I imagine the conversation going in my head, at least. Alright, so Duster and Dempsey, I know you guys are here for Full Boost Esports. Who is your player to watch? Because I already went over mine. I said Okenshee is my player to watch because he's a defensive monster. The man had some crazy clears the last time I cast him. Really set up a lot of their offensive rotation off his sidewall play. And this man says all of them, they're all players to watch. You can't have an MVP if it's your team's full of them, right? So do I have any Taka Esports fans in here? We need to get the alternative perspective. So if there's any Taka Esports fans, let me know. Yo, Big Blue Cube in here. I'm looking to cast his game on Sunday night. I believe at 10 p.m., right? I don't think I've accepted yours yet, just because I don't know. I'm taking my mom out for Mother's Day. She was recently in the hospital, so I'm not quite sure how late I'm going to be out with her. But I don't think it's going to go till 10 p.m., so I think I should. I'll be able to cast your guys' game. So Big Blue Cube, a member of Power Gaming White, and they will play Afternoon Delight here on the stream at 10 p.m. Eastern on Sunday. And Big Blue Cube and company, my mom is hanging out with next week with me. Aw, yeah. Yeah. I'm going to try and take her out. I'm going to try and treat her right. Like I said, she was just recently in the hospital. She just got out. So, me and my brother are gonna try and do something special for her. As, it was a little bit of a shock. My brother called me on at work on the morning. She was like, hey, I had to take mom to the hospital. I'm like, I just saw her yesterday. She's perfectly fine. But, yeah, I'm glad she's out too. Thank you, man. It's days like that where you really get reminded just, you know, how much your family means to you. So, in light of that, we'll have some fun on Sunday. So what are your plans, Big Blue Cube? What are you guys doing? Taking her out to breakfast, lunch? As Taka Esports rolling on in. So Jabberwocky, Geek Boy, and Cabria. Yeah, I have a buddy who recently was my roommate. He actually moved back to Long Island. And I think I'm actually going to see him at the beginning of June. I have a week off from work. I might just go up and see him. He seems like he's having the time of his life. He really missed his family, so he moved back up there. And he got like a crazy job operating on generators now, like industrial generators. It's nuts. And thank you for the follow, Dempsey Hammer. Jack Dempsey himself in chat, reincarnated into this man's soul. So our plan was actually to go fishing. So I've not been fishing since I was 6 years old, and I was like a crazy, like, hyperactive kid, so I could not sit still in a boat for like 6 hours. But like, now that I'm like old and like can sit for hours at a time and just like to relax and drink beer, it's like, it seems like it's the perfect thing for me to do. So I think we're gonna go fishing. Yo, what up, Chef? Happy Friday to you, my man. We have one more matchup for tonight. It's a tier 5 3v3 between Full Boost, who I've cast before, and Taka Esports. So both these teams relatively close in their standings and stats. And it's going to really come down to which team can kind of just create that offensive pressure first, get those rotations in, and score that pivotal first goal, which I think is really going to decide every game in this series. So whoever scores first, I think, is probably going to just take the game, as both these teams have a tight defensive rotation. As we wait on Chantazer and company to join in. Hell yeah, golfing and fishing are tied for the best drinking sports. And Geek Boy Axe, thank you for the follow. He's going to be playing right next up as Geek Boy, a member of Taka Esports. So Taka, so Geek Boy, who is your player to watch on your squad? Who's going to get it done for you guys tonight? As the other team starting to file in here. All right. All right. So we have all these squads facing off. Let's go down to the pitch. We have full boost on the blue side. Oakenshee, Chantazer, and Bliv against Geek Boy. And this one, a shot to the far side. Bliv trying to turn it back. Shot on by Oak as this one deflected away. Geek Boy, Chantazer with a chance, and he dunks it in. And the Musk game, thank you for the follow as well. As Chantazer gets up to this ball in a hurry. Cabria not able to find it after Bliv kind of hustling that defensive rotation over, looking for a few bumps to disrupt the rotation. Jabber can't get the clear as Bliv hops in. Jabber back down in front. Chance here for Oak. Open net shot, and Cabria not able to get back. And Oak, my player to watch on the side of full boost, just patiently awaits this ball. Like I said, he is a key part of their defensive rotation as he found the long clear passes. And on the other side, Geek Boy, the team captain, my player to watch for the side of Taka. As I don't know why my overlays are all messed up. Hold on, boys. It's currently game one. I'm sorry about that. As the shot and Chantes are not going on, as Cabria gonna let Geek Boy clear this one in and chip and chase. Oak off the side. Well, Cabria back out in front. Chance here for Jabber as Oak takes this one away. 2v1 downfield. He'll take the shot off the pipe. Back out in front. Can't get it. Bliv with a shot as this one gonna hop off the sidewall. Jabber able to clear it down to mid and relieve some of that pressure as Cabria gonna step up. Tries to take the shot. Makes it out off the sidewall. Still back out in front. And Geek gets a touch, but it's wide as this one back down. Bliv deflects it away. Cabria gonna turn back in on it. Broken up by Bliv. Geek Boy sends it down. Chantes are just gonna rotate in and steal the boost, but now 2v1 the other way. Bliv will just wait on the wall touch. Bliv as Cabria. Good pre-flip into it. Has Chantes to beat. Cabria against Chan as he cuts back in. And a great challenge by Chantaser as Cabria had a good opportunity out in front as Jabber. A dangerous clear across. He'll take it deep to corner. He'll try and flip her over to it. Cabria with a shot attempt. And that one on. Chantazer able to locate it as Jabber misses on that. Geek Boy just going to rotate back to net. Now he'll challenge as this one goes back out in front. Kept in by Bliv. Good offensive rotation here from full boost. Oak, he'll wait for the center off the sidewall. Back down in front for Bliv and Chan as they combine for a shot. And full boost taking game one in a hurry. 3-0. Still plenty of time on the clock. But going to be an uphill battle, at least in game one for Taka. Good demo off the bat for Cabria. Jabber. The 50 comes underneath as Oak blocks that one away. Geek Boy to the backboard. Good chance here from Chantazer. Back out of front. Bliv Can't get to it, but a good rotation by Jabber to get across. Oak. Long clear from Jabberwocky. They'll chip and chase as Bliv hustles back. Doesn't get the best touch chance here for Cabrera as Chantazer flies in for a block. Cabrera. Good rotation. Good pass out in front, and Oak cuts it under. Cabrera takes the initial touch back out in front. Oak able to bury it on the goal line. And Chantazer has been all over the field here for full boost. Chan. A great feed out in front. Oak right on the doorstep. And Taka just going to try and build some momentum for game two instead. Jabber. Long clear. This one going to hop down to corner as Bliv. Cabrera is going to await this one. Clears it down into corner as Jabber. Slammed away by Chan. Jabber keeps this one alive. They'll look to get a demo on the goalie as this one out in front of Chantazer. Able to hop away. Cabrera, good feed. Bliv can't get the blocking in as Geek Boy puts one away. The captain trying to come back in this game, but Cabrera has been setting up a lot of the offense here for Taka. Hey, Geek Boy, Johnny on the spot, able to put one in, trying to come back into this game with a minute 34 left. Jabber. That's a long shot. Oak trying to get up to it and able to get a touch as Geek Boy could calmly take this one in. Geek Boy to the short side as Bliv will hop out to mid. Bliv look for an air shot off the sidewall, back down the front, and Jabber able to get the long clear. Chantazer can't locate it. Still back out in front. Chance here again for Taka as a whiff comes out. Okenshi back down to mid. Geek Boy, good block down to Jabber. Jabber, he'll just wait on this one as Chantazer takes a hold. Geek Boy, deflection to the far side. Bliv, not going to challenge yet as Jabber puts it down mid. Chance here for full, and Okenshi making the best of it after an unfortunate touch from Taka. Jabber was trying to put it mid for Geek Boy with a little pass, a little give and go play. But Full Boost hops the route. And 5-1. Jabber. Good lead pass. Can't find Geek Boy. But now he'll try a second time as puts it far side to Cabrera. The actual score is 5-1. But it was, this is still game one. Okenshi. Shot out in front as Geek Boy deflects it across. And some good defense here from Taka right at the end. Like I said, seems like a team with solid rotations. But Full Boost taking game one. Just had too much hot sauce. So we go to game two. Jabber. An offensive force getting a lot of touches for Taka. Hoping to see Cabrera take a little bit more of a role in the offense. He seemed like a good player that can control the ball extremely well, makes good game decisions, and has good game sense. So we'll see how game two goes. They were building some momentum at the end of game one. Yucateco habanero. All right, my man, I was actually thinking about doing a the hot sauce challenge with the wings as one of my stream, like like a special like event stream, I should say. As Cabria through mid, Cabria trying to rush that one down as Bliv sends a deep Jabberwocky, gonna punch it back in. Oh. Last man for a second as Jabber gets a center. That one is going to float in off the post. Back out in front and Bliv. Able to send it in. Bliv cuts it back mid. Jabber doing a good job challenging. Okenshi can't get it out to mid. Okenshi a long shot. Jabber. That flicks up. Chance Hazer with a chance as he puts it to the sidewall. Cabria. Deflects it away, kept in by Bliv. Cabria. Back down Okenshi to mid. Long shot from Geek Boy goes wide. Cabria gonna let Jabberwocky take a blast. That one just gonna skirt the ground and Okenshi will be able to pick it up. Geek Boy bumped by Chantazer. The demo rotation from Chantazer tried to come through. Okenshi, big feet out in front. Bliv able to find it. And full boost. Taking the first goal of this game. So like I said, guys, in my opinion, the team that strikes first is going to be probably the team that takes it. These two teams so evenly matched on the defensive front. As Chantazer. Miss hit there. Chance here for Jabber. Can't get the shot away. Geek Boy up for this is Okenshi with a long clear. Cabria to Jabberwocky. Long clear. Chantazer keeps it alive as Geek Boy. Trying to come back inside. That one hop short as Bliv can't get it. Okenshi last man. He'll try and buy time, but this one gonna hop out to Geek Boy. Shot to the short side and in. Geek Boy making him pay for the missed touch. Okenshi tried to pinch that one towards midfield. Ends up running back out in front of Geek Boy. A great read. Sataka doing a good job finding that offense here in game two as Jabber slams it back down. Chance here. Cabria steps into it as Chant to the far side. Chantazer gets a block trying to free up his team as Bliv will hop in. Jabber over him as Okenshi turns it back. Chan. Right over to Geek Boy. Shot as Bliv. Gonna block it away. Jabber. Can't get it on the sidewall. Back out in front. Chance here as Okenshi takes the shot, but Jabber can't control as Okenshi. Dangerous ball as two players hounding him on offense. Cabria. That one. Hops out in front towards midfield. The dunk as nobody able to touch it. Jabber. We'll whiff on that as Bliv tries to cut it back in mid. Cabria gets a touch. Chantazer a shot to the far side. Jabber gonna leave this one as Okenshi back towards mid. Chance here for Chantazer, but Bliv gonna step in to play it off the sidewall. Chantazer right into Geek Boy. Bliv can't get a piece of it as this one will skip right out in front. Jabber takes the 50 on Okenshi. Cabria back down to mid. Jabber able to take it again, but Bliv trying to get a center out of it as Geek Boy puts it right back into Okenshi. Short side shot. Back out in front. Nobody able to get a Chantazer. Able to bury it out in front as full boost. Take the one goal lead again, and great initial shot by Oak as it goes off the post, but back out in front for Chantazer. And full boost. Taking the lead again. Okenshi whiffs on that as Jabberwocky able to tie it up in a hurry. Jabber, a great follow, noticing that the players on full boost have struggled with some of these corner hits, not knowing where they were going to go, and fully capitalizing on it. So good gameplay adjustment from Taka Esports. That one out in front. Okenshi forced to make the save as Cabria was right on the goal line. Cabria Good touch over. Gets another as Bliv can't get a Geek Boy pinch out in front. Chance here for Taka Esports. Flying in. Jabber gets the shot away, but Cabrio, next man up off the post as Geek Boy send it back. Geek Boy. Okenshi up the sidewall. Jabber the far side. Chantes are able to track that one down as Cabria. Back pass. Okenshi. Long shot. Geek Boy, a huge save. As Taka Esports has looked really good on the defensive side of the ball in this game, especially. Jabber. Big feed out in front. Can't find Geek Boy as these offensive chances just going back and forth between the two teams. Cabria gets a hit up. Jabberwocky, long shot. Okenshi, big save. As my players to watch, not disappointing. Okenshi, a monster on defense. And Geek Boy doing a good job setting up the offense as Jabber hops back in. Cabria shot blocked out by Chantazer. Pass from Okenshi, broken up by Geek Boy. One last rush. Geek Boy, a chance to center. This one up for grabs. Chantazer out to mid. Maybe one last rush here for the other team. Okenshi tries to put that one on as Geek is going to kill it. So we go to overtime here in game two. A long clear in as Chantazer will leave this one. Jabberwocky looking for a 50 as Okenshi able to get the clear out to mid. Okenshi right into Cabria. He'll look for the demo rotation instead as Chantazer sends it on in. Geek Boy through mid. Okenshi to the far side. Jabberwocky gonna beat him to this ball. Never mind. Okenshi going for that challenge on the wall. No boost. And now 2v1 the other way. Jabber shot as this is a floater. It's gonna come out to Geek Boy as he'll wait this. He'll play it off the sidewall. And Okenshi will be able to turn this aside. Cabria. Good dunk down, setting up. Jabber! Jabber! A shot as Chantazer doesn't get the best touch on it, and Okenshi right there to help him out. Deflection goes to the far side. Chantazer can't get the hit, so Bliv will take over. This one, shot to the far side, and Cabria able to push it out again. Okenshi, pre-flip shot, but Jabber sends it back down as Chantazer was last man. Chan, long shot. Geek Boy, last man. Geek Boy, big save on the goal line. As he'll try and take a shot of his own as Bliv teeing that one up for Okenshi. Bliv. Chantazer can't get a hold of that one. Okenshi needs to get over in a hurry and does as Geek Boy clears the corner. Bliv trying to find it. Skips back out in front. Chantazer sends it back down into Cabria. Bliv can't locate it. The wave dash from Jabber. Cabria, great 50 underneath. Still has some boost. He's going to let his teammate rotate in. Never mind. He'll take the chance now. Cabria deflected away as Bliv looking for a long clear. Geek Boy up for this one. Dope back down in center. Chance as Okenshi. Last man again. Bliv can't cut it back in as Geek Boy drives the net. And they will take game two. A great play set up there by Jabberwocky. Geek Boy, the captain, coming in clutching game two in overtime. And Okenshi, a large total for his team, but just not enough. Here as Geek Boy puts up some impressive numbers. 2 goals, 3 saves all over the field. So we go to game three, all tied up, 1 apiece. Jabber a lot more aggressive in game two as well. Taking a lot more shots, not trying to hold onto the ball. Just clearing it downfield, allowing his team to rotate in as fast as they can. and resulted in some prime opportunities as some of those balls in the corner, like I said, Fulbu's not able to read too terribly well. And Taka Esports taking full advantage. So the lineups will stay the same. A demo right off the face-off by Geek Boy. Jabber, not able to hit it, so Cabrio will step up to help out. 50, in by Chantaser. Jabber walking dangerous clear across front. Oakenshee to the far post, and Geek Boy not able to get it in time. And Bliv, they would have popped the open net. Oakenshee, a great pass out in front, not putting a lot on it. Just enough to get it to the far corner for Bliv. So 1-0, full boost. Long clear in as Geek. Back to mid. Chan misses the pre-flip as Jabber. He'll look for a center. Quick touch as Bliv. Able to get the block out. Cabrio will await that shot as Chantaser. Put it back in. This one going to skip out to mid. Oakenshee. Shot. Far side. Off the post. Back down in front. Bliv. Off the sidewall. Still there. And Jabber. Able to get the clear down. He'll look to pressure as he has some speed. Look out. Jabber. Gets a demo. And this one kept in by Geek. Cabria. Good offensive rotation here from Taka. Jabber. Keeping it alive. Chantaser. The pinch comes back. Make Geek Boy up for this one. Sends it in. Oakenshee. 50 and underneath. Chance here for Jabber as that one he can't locate on that far side. Oakenshee cuts it past it. Geek Boy sends it off the wall. Jabber plays it to himself. Plenty of space. Jabber looking for a little ground pinch as Bliv stepped into by Cabria. Geek Boy can't get the shot as this one. Jabber, good touch. Chantaser, last man back. Pushes it to corner, and he'll clear safely through mid. Jabber trying to play it down to Geek Boy, but already on the rotation back. Oakenshee steps in front of that one. He'll turn it back towards midfield. He'll get over one. Oakenshee, plenty of space in front of him. Chance here for him to center. Oakenshee misses on the ball, and Jabber can't get a hold of it either. Second chance. As Oakenshee gets it over to Chantaser. Jabber gonna leave it for Geek Boy. He'll chip and chase downfield. Geek. And again, Oakenshee has been the defensive force that has been driving full boost. Oakenshee down in. Downward off that as Cabria. Gonna send this one deep. Cabria shot to the short side. That one. Turned aside by Bliv. Jabber. Back down in front. Chance for him to 50 as Chantaser has pushed it through. Taka. Playing the grinders game as they are trying to keep this one alive. Good pressure here from Taka. Chantaser. He'll pinch this one along, but with zero boost, Geek Boy. Gonna send it back in. Bliv. Deflection. Chance here for Geek Boy as Bliv. Flex it back out. Jabber just going to leave it in midfield. It looks for a back pass as Chantaser hops the route instead. He finally gets a clear downfield as full boost needed to relieve some of that pressure. Now they'll look to get going the other way. Jabber. That one sent over to Bliv. Back pass as Oakenshee going to take it. Dangerous 50 out in front. And Jabber up over one. Chantaser last man to beat. And Bliv. Deflecting that from the back challenge. The ball control off the wall for Fuel Boost is crazy. As Cab going for a ceiling shot. Jabber flex it back around. Oakenshee is going to wait as Bliv clears it to the far side. Chantaser back in as Geek Boy play that off him. Bliv kept out as this one cut underneath. Jabberwocky, nobody to beat as he has a completely open net. Jabber off the post and in, and able to tie it up with just under a minute left. Jabber sees that Fulbrew's getting a little greedy with their rotation on offense, sending the house to net. Able to cut it past one and equalize this game. Cabrera not able to find it, this one. And we played into Geek Boy, a little bump on the rotation there from Full Boost. Chantazer. Looks for a deflection back down. Geek Boy gonna kick this one out as Okinshi steps into it. Geek Boy, cross mid, has some space, takes the shot to the far side. That is Bliv. The sidewall broken up by Jabber. Right into Chantazer. This one. Long ball, side ball, back out in front, and Geek Boy, Captain Clutch, with 14 seconds left. Taka, able to bury another one. Geek Boy, great job hopping the defensive route, getting in that passing lane, sending it all the way down, and what a follow through as Taka. It all comes down to this faceoff now for Full Boost. Okinshi wins it back. Jabber, he's gonna try and buy time through mid, beats one. Back out as Cabrera, open net, chance to seal it, and puts it in. Cabrera putting a nail in the proverbial coffin as Taka again come back in game three to win it. And what a job by Geek Boy, the captain of Taka Esports. Getting that goal, staying consistently pressured on the offensive rotation. Taka ate up a lot of clock. Just keeping the ball in the zone of Full Boost. Those are three saves. Shot totals are the same, but Taka ahead where it counts on the scoreboard. And they take game three, so we go to game four. Taka with a chance to close it out here against Full Boost. Full Boost gonna try and force a game five. Okinshi has been my player to watch, and he has been stellar thus far defensively. Bliv, back down. This one, still out in front. Chance here, chance here. Stuffed out by Geek Boy. Somehow, some way, made the save. As Geek Boy, so I'm trying to collect that big pad. Bliv, you send this one along. Jabber, back out in front is Geek Boy. Gonna push it down. Geek Boy, good 50. Chantes are forced to step up. As Jabber, just gonna wait. This touchdown right into Bliv's car. Jabber. Gonna rotate back for some boost as Cabrera looks to track that one down. Can't get the hit. This one, Okinshi. Just gonna leave it for Bliv. Bliv over to Cabrera. Good challenge by Chantazer as the shot was about to come through. Okinshi. He'll flick this one up, look for the demo rotation, but Geek Boy steps up into it. And now he's 1v1 against Chantazer for a second. Chant. Good touch to mid, broken up by Jabber. He's gonna look for a little double tap off the backboard. And Okinshi will send this one down. Okinshi, little bit of space, looks for a center, back out in front to Bliv, and can't bury it as Chantazer takes a chance, and he goes short side. Bliv, a quality chance out in front. Chantazer just following through. They send the house, and they are looking to consistently pressure here again in this game. Not taking their foot off the gas pedal. Full Boost. Chantazer gets a touch, but Jabber plays it up the sidewall to Cabrera. Back down. Jabber takes the shot. As Cabrera is going to retreat for Boost. Geek Boy. This one. Deflected back as Bliv takes a little bit of an ambitious pre-jump there. Jabber. That's a good hit. Jabber looking for center. Good touch. Back down in front. And this one still not done yet. Cabrera. Big feet. Geek Boy with a shot. And Bliv, a huge save. Chantazer Now looking to go the other way. This one gonna hop back down. Enchant Taser. Can't get the shot as Jabber. Back down off the sidewall. Liv. Into this one. Shot by Geek Boy. Goes in off the crossbar and down. Geek Boy has been an offensive force here for Taka Esports tonight. And this man's placement has been picture perfect as he beats the defender high to the short side. Taka sent two members as this one all the way back down. Chance for a Chantazer as Geek Boy able to get the clear. Geek Boy look for a demo rotation, but Jabber can't get the touch as they'll leave this one for Cabria. Chantazer, long shot. And a block away by Geek Boy. Geek Boy has had Chantazer's number all series long as Okinchi. He shot at Cabria. Flex this one away. He dunked back down by Jabber. Jabber. The far side, Cabria Sino with a chance to flex it in. Cabria. But what a play by Jabber. Just forcing his way through mid. The 50 and the demo come out. And that one would have gone in regardless. Jabber doing the brunt of the work. Okinchi. Down as Bliv takes this one across mid. Jabber. Back into Chantazer. Chan. Touch to the backboard. Nobody there yet as Bliv was a second late to the party. Now Okinchi trying to get the deflection. Chantazer. Go across mid. Let Bliv take the shot as nobody hits this one. Now Cabria. Down off the sidewall. Okinchi. Step into this as Jabber. Puts it far side to Geek Boy. Jabber. Cabria. We'll let Geek Boy handle this. It rushed down to mid as Bliv breaks that one up and will advance through. Bliv gets a demo from Okinchi. Okinchi on the warpath looking for another bump. Bliv can't cut it mid in time as Chantazer was trailing that play. Okinchi to the backboard. Down in front. Bliv with a chance as Geek Boy will clear it under him. 45 seconds left. Full Boost need a goal and they need one now as they are looking to get downfield. Cabria not going to let him. Okinchi through mid. Looking for a pass. That's actually a shot instead. Two players up as Bliv turns it back towards mid. He dunked down. Cabria can't advance it. Now look out. Okinchi the other way. 2v1. Jabber, last man. Bliv shot off the sidewall. Back down in front. And this one will skirt wide as Chantazer takes it up the wall. 10 seconds. Full Boost need a goal. Need to rush the ball and do. Chantazer back up to mid. This one gonna float down. Still a chance here for Okinchi, but he whiffs on the ball. And Taka Esports able to take the series 3-1. No problem, boys. What a series. Taka Esports, definitely a team to watch. Geek Boy coming out as captain clutch here tonight. Jabber was all over the field as well. Even though he did get third place in that, he was a main driving force in keeping the offense going. Cabria, excellent game sense. And Taka, going to be a dangerous team come playoff time. Full Boost, doing a good job nonetheless here tonight. As Okinchi, again, a driving force on that defense, but their control of the ball is really what impresses me about Full Boost. Able to take it and kind of create plays on their own, finding their teammates across the field, and Precast, thank you for the follow. And Fulbu is definitely looking to look to bounce back again next week as we head towards playoffs. I'm sure both of these teams are top 16 in their division, as this did not look like a tier 5 matchup to me. Both these teams are extremely good at playing the ball, and the rotations were pretty crisp. So guys, that will be all for tonight. If you guys can stick around, I will raid one of the other IGL casters. We do try and support each other as much as we can. Spread some love throughout the community, making sure everyone gets a fair chance to get a lot of viewers in, seeing what they're made of, and kind of getting a chance for you guys to show off for the audience, you know. So that is going to be it for me tonight. Guys, if you liked what you heard, liked what you saw, drop a follow like to my man Jabberwocky right there, who had just played Taka Esports, coming out strong, taking the dub 3-1 here tonight. And like I said, a dangerous team come playoff time, as they were able to take the ball all over the field tonight. Cabria, in my opinion, a crazy strong player, which was just game sense alone, knowing when to go for the ball, really picky about his challenges. Yeah, Schmidt, it was a blast to cast you guys. I hope you can set something up come playoff time, because I think you guys are going to be in it too now too. You're 4-1. Or 5-1? 4-1. Maybe. I don't know. But guys, we are going to try and find another IGL person to host here. As I'm looking through. As it looks like. Looking like Abacus is actually streaming right now. So we'll hit him with a parade. Alright, no problem, Dempsey. I'm so glad that I got to meet you guys tonight. That's awesome that your name is actually Jack Dempsey. And I hope you guys will be back. We're going to go raid Abacus right now. So guys, just stick around. You don't actually earn channel points, because I am not an affiliate, even with my close to 800 followers, just because I do not like the Twitch contract. And I plan on restreaming and multi-streaming in the future. But we're going to go raid him. And guys, when you get in there, just tell him Gil sent you. Hope you guys have a wonderful rest of your weekend. Peace and love.
Go, love to see everybody coming in there saying GG's in the chat, but I'm gonna go ahead and back out. Let's go back to our just chatting screen there for the moment. Gil Thane's coming in with the raid of 7. How is it going? How was your casting there as we wait for the members of Believable Brothers to hop back in here? And since that's a raid of more than 5, and thank you for the follow, Gil Thanes. Much appreciated. Since that's a raid of more than 5, as everybody who is here at the channel knows, when there's a raid of 5 or more, I do what is called the Burning Bean Challenge. There's Sriracha, Jalapeno, Habanero, Carolina Reaper, and Jalapeno. And this time it lands on, it's hard to read there because of my green screen. That is a Habanero, being the orange one, moving up there with the heat. Just as that match was on fire, so will this Burning Bean Challenge go. And again, if somebody subscribes to the channel, raids with more than 5, or gift subs, I should say, subs or gift subs, raids with more than 5, or uses 3,000 channel points, I do a Burning Bean Challenge. Ooh, hoo-hoo. Cast was nuts. 2 tier 1 teams from your league play teams both got dubs. Last game was a series was tier 5, but they played like it was tier 2. Wow. That sounds like an awesome caster, Gil Thanes. Cool. So after that, whew, burning beans here. Let's see if I can get in and do this interview with Regretty Spaghetti and Good Schmud. Sorry, I was doing a burning beans challenge there. Now, after that, I have the habanero breath going on.
I was waiting for you to say Good Schmud. I'm like, is he just going to say me?
Oh, no, it's just a burning in the back of the net. But,